Hello world, John Yamasato here, and welcome to another episode of High Sessions. I forgot my handheld camera today, so I'm going to be doing this with SLRs and tripods and stuff. Our guest today, Ian O'Sullivan. Ian is a classically trained guitarist, wonderful guitarist that's going to be coming on the show, so check it out, man. Thank you to Vol for my shirt, and have a good one.
Dave Kusumoto.
What's up?
I have nothing. I don't even have anything interesting to ask you.
And I don't have anything interesting to say.
All right. See ya. Yeah. I need to ask you, what kind of guitar are you playing?
It's a Christopher Carrington. He's a luthier in Texas. Used to tour with Al Di Meola. What's nice about this guitar is So he's a fabulous performer as well.
Okay.
Which isn't common for a luthier, necessarily. So he knows what a player wants to get out of the instrument. It's got a great pickup inside. It's Indian rosewood, spruce. David Russell, famous classical guitarist, signed the side.
Cool.
Just so I get some inspiration.
And it looks like it's got some mileage on it.
Oh, definitely.
So you have played it.
I think I got it in 2000 and...
Uh-huh.
2005 I got it.
So almost 10 years old.
Yeah, and I bought it from my teacher, Ben Verdery.
Okay,
and
cool.
So it was built in 2002. He played it for a couple years, and then I bought it off of him.
Very nice instrument.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm here, or we are here, with Ian O'Sullivan for our 3-minute interview, which is going to start... go for it. Now, Ian, great guitar playing, man. Where did you learn how to play classical style and finger picking and all that stuff?
Classical guitar, I started at UH Manoa in 2002, I think. I started studying with Jeff Peterson.
I didn't know he taught over there.
Yeah, he taught there for a brief period, for about a year and a half, and then he left for a tour, came back for a semester, and then he left permanently. at which time I continued studying with a variety of teachers, Darren Au, who's at Punahou.
Oh, I know Darren.
Yeah. Lisa Smith, your previous teacher as well.
Yeah.
And then Jeff turned me on to Benjamin Verdery, the teacher from Yale University, and he does a workshop every summer on Maui in Kihei. And so I attended that for 7 years. I think it was the sixth year that I started thinking about applying for graduate programs and filled out the application for Yale. And I was able to get a full tuition scholarship to Yale University for 2 years, getting my master's. And so that's where I was from 2009 to 2011. And then they provided a bunch of different master classes, great workshops from famous classical guitarists from around the world. And then I got the lectureship in guitar back at UH Manoa, and so I've been here for almost 2 years.
Oh, okay, teaching.
Teaching again, yeah.
It comes full circle.
The position that Jeff originally held, actually.
So. Now, Dave walked away, but Darren Au and I used to play at a coffee shop a long time ago. So there's a little history there, too, with Jake, myself, and Darren.
Oh, wow.
And Darren would play guitar, I would play bass, and Jake would play keyboard and kazoo. I'm serious. It was fun. It was a good time. And Dave used to play too. I don't know if Dave was there with Darren, but I do remember that. That was a long time. Okay. Nick?
Yeah. Did you start on the guitar? Is your first musical instrument?
I started on the ukulele. Yeah. That was when I could have even been 4 years old or something like that. I found one, under my parents' bed probably. And my dad knew how to play Maui chimes and showed me how to play that song. and that was the only song I knew how to play for like 5 years. And then I had a friend at school who would play all these songs in the ukulele, and I asked him, well, how did you learn those? And he said, oh, I just sat down with a recording. And I was blown away that you could learn songs by ear. And so I went home, and then the only songs I could really hear consistently were the Ice Cream Man song. So that was one of the first songs I learned how to play. You know, picking out Star Wars melodies, things like that, songs I knew from the top of my head. And then, you know, recordings were hard to come by. I think Kyle Creator Boys, you know, was one of the first albums I ever got to sit down with. CDs came out when I was in like 8th grade or something. Cool. And so before that, I would 7th grade, I sat down with cassette tapes, you know, playing by ear, using the tape so much that by the time I was done with it, it would be all warbled in certain places because those are the difficult sections. Yeah, and then I started the guitar in high school, playing in a rock band.
Cool, man. Well, our 3 minutes is up, but you've come a long way. Your guitar playing is phenomenal. So thanks for coming on the show, and we will hope to see you again.
Great. Thank you.